Today we are continuing with abstract writing, and today we'll know what are the types of abstracts and what is the difference between informative or descriptive abstract. You can see the screen, I hope. So, an abstract is a condensed content of a complete report or project or story, which should include the key elements of the entire content. Now moving on, types of abstracts. You can write an abstract on descriptive or informative. In the earlier class you had seen that there are four writing styles, and you will be choosing these styles as per the situation, according to the situation what it is or what you are going to write. And the descriptive writing style or the informative writing style can be included and marked as descriptive abstracts or informative abstracts. Now let us take a look at the descriptive abstract. In descriptive abstracts, you do not inform. You move ahead to describe. You are describing the key elements, the main points of your entire story. Now, for example, you can write a descriptive abstract on any book which you have read, any report which you have read. The success story of anybody. You can write a success story of, take any celebrity, take any personality. Experiments with Truth by Jawaharlal Nehru. Mahatma Gandhi has written a lot of books in his civilization and culture. So you can write also a descriptive or informative abstract as per the lessons you have learned. For example, you can write an abstract, a descriptive abstract on Rahul Bajaj. You have learned, you have read his story. You can write about Subhash Chandra. You can write about Narayan Murthy. I mean, the content already is written. You are supposed to write only the abstract. When you are writing descriptive abstracts, which are usually based on humanities like social science, sociology, anthropology, any people, any person. But this type of abstract is usually very short, like 50 to 100 words. It can include one paragraph, just one paragraph. And most descriptive abstracts have certain key points in common, what they should be about, what you should write about. So you're going to use this descriptive abstracts for humanities and social sciences, which I just said, or in papers of psychology, social skills, when you're writing about any personality. For example, I told you to write about any person, the story which you have already written in your first semester. Now, what are you going to include? So most descriptives have certain key parts in common, and which are the background. Here you are going to include the background of, if you are talking about Rahul Bajaj. You will not write the essay or the summary once again, but you will just include one or two sentences about his background. For example, what kind of family he belongs to. So, your abstract should contain the background of your content. The purpose for you writing this paragraph, this abstract on Rahul Bajaj. The purpose. Particular interest and focus of the paper. So what is the focus of the paper? What do you want to include in the paper? And overview of the content. You can exclude the overview by just writing the key elements. And in each section, for example, you're starting with his early life. A few sentences about his early life. A sentence about his school, about his college, about his hometown, about Oxford where he went for his MBA. Why he was rejected first. And then you go on to write about his life, his children, his wife, his children, his life on the whole. His family, Rahul Bajaj as a family man, Rahul Bajaj as a professional person. You are going to just write a few sentences from each area. Do you understand? Did you understand? Now your assignment number one is you write an abstract or any celebrity which you know. If you have read any book, write the abstract. Somebody else's content, you write the abstract. So the easiest is writing an abstract on any three of the celebrities, personalities you have read in your semester. All right? Your own story?
Yes, sir.
You have written. Okay. वेरी गुड. अगर आपने अपनी कोई कहानी लिखी है, आई नेवर न्यू यू आर अ राइटर. इज द स्टोरी इन हिंदी और इंग्लिश? व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ द स्टोरी?
मैम कंटेंट अभी प्रोसेस में था, थोड़ा फुल स्टोरी के भी वॉल्यूम बेस पे था, जितने सोच
रहा. डिडंट आई टेल यू दैट first you complete your writing and sabse baad mein in the end you will write the abstract. The first you what you will have to do, you have to complete the story first and then you write the abstract. So you are trying to delay things ki first I will finish, no wo finish hoga na main abstract likhunga.
No, don't try to the story one or two days.
Okay, that is another thing, that is your extra work. फॉर विच यू विल बी गिवन एक्स्ट्रा प्राइस. कोई बच्चा अगर अपनी क्रिएटिविटी दिखा रहा है क्लास में, खुद से कहानियाँ लिख रहा है, उसका एब्स्ट्रैक्ट लिख रहा है, तो नेचुरली ही विल बी अवॉर्डेड बाई सिमेज ऑल्सो. एंड अदरवाइज असाइनमेंट्स आर ऑलवेज असाइनमेंट्स. यू राइट एन एब्स्ट्रैक्ट ऑन एनी थ्री ऑफ द फॉलोइंग: राहुल बजाज, सुभाष चंद्र एंड नारायण मूर्ति. So in this it will be descriptive. You are describing. You are not informing the reader, but you are informing. Sorry, you are not informing, but you are describing. The next we come to the second part. The second type of abstract is the informative abstract. As you already know, that the informative means giving guidelines, the technical know-how of any report which you have compiled, any research work which you have done. So informative abstracts are generally used for science, engineering or psychology reports. You must get the essence of what your report is about. So first of all, you must know the feel, the main soul of your report. Usually, in about 200 words, most informative abstracts also have key parts in common. And each of these parts might consist of one or two sentences. As I said, each segment, each part, a couple of sentences only. In this also, the background should be there. Even purpose of a research. For example, I give you an assignment of write a thesis or write a project on coronavirus in Bihar, in Patna. What is life after coronavirus? तो आप क्या करेंगे, आपको research करना पड़ेगा. How will you compile the data? बताइए. पहले आप तो क्वेश्चन है बनाएंगे, इंटरव्यू मेथड करेंगे. यू विल स्टार्ट इंटरव्यूइंग पीपल. नो, बाय रीडिंग, नॉट बाय रीडिंग आर्टिकल्स, वन टू वन इंटरव्यू. यस, यू टेल मी यू आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम पीपल हु हैव सफर्ड कोविड 19 एंड हु हैव रिकवर्ड. What is their life today? तो उनसे आप बात करेंगे, उनका इंटरव्यू लेंगे और पता लगाएंगे how it has affected his family, how it has affected him, how it has affected his job. So this is different from the descriptive, isn't it? Descriptive, you're writing something which already is written. यहाँ पर आपको research करना पड़ेगा. In the last batch, I gave a report to write on unemployed graduates in Bihar. So they interviewed 100 students who were graduates, who were unemployed. So they came to know a lot of things. These things even you have to do. You have to write both the reports. In this, I am not giving you to, in the descriptive, I am not asking you to write an article. The article already is written, you are only writing the report, the abstract. And the informative abstract, you do some research work, talk to 10, 20, 30 people, 100 people, prepare. Interview them and come up with the findings, right? So first, background. Why are you preparing a report on the after effects of coronavirus? Background ho gaya. Aim and purpose of the research. What good will it this be? Purpose kya hai research ka? So that you make people aware. Methods used. क्या मेथड आपने यूज़ किया, अगर आप ऑलरेडी बना चुके हैं अपनी रिपोर्ट अपना, तो आप एब्स्ट्रैक्ट में ही सब लिखेंगे, मैंने क्या मेथड यूज़ किया है, मैंने क्वेश्चन है मेथड यूज़ किया है, मैंने इंटरव्यू मेथड यूज़ किया है, कहाँ के लोगों को हमने इंटरव्यू लिया है। अब लोग क्या कहेंगे, उनके एक आध दो लाइन आप बोल सकते हैं, बट यू विल नॉट गिव द एंटायर इंटरव्यू इन द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट। यू कैन इंक्लूड अ फ्यू सेंटेंसेज, अ फ्यू क्वेश्चंस, क्वेश्चंस विच वर आस्क्ड टू द पीपल, वो आप डाल सकते हैं मेथड्स यूज में। फाइंडिंग्स एंड रिजल्ट्स, इफ यू हैव इंटरव्यूड 100 पीपल, व्हाट इज द फाइंडिंग, क्या जाने हैं आप, क्या सामने आया, प्लस रिजल्ट क्या है, एंड फाइनली द कंक्लूजन। नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द डिस्क्रिप्टिव एंड द The difference between descriptive abstract and informative abstract. A descriptive abstract describes the major points of the project to the reader. An informative abstract informs the audience of all essential points of the paper. So descriptive describes and informative informs. The descriptive abstract includes the background, purpose and focus of the paper or article, but never the method, result and conclusion if it is a research paper. But the informative abstract briefly summarizes the background, purpose, focus, method, results, findings, and conclusions of the full-length paper. Thirdly, a descriptive abstract is most likely to use for humanities and social sciences paper or psychology essays. Social science, it means subjects like sociology, psychology, anthropology, and informative abstract is concise, usually 10% of the original paper length. So the paper is 100%, the abstract will be just 10% of the entire content, and often just one paragraph. is most likely used for sciences, engineering or psychology reports. Also, an example of an abstract. Here are two abstracts with the key parts identified. The descriptive abstract one is for humanities paper, and the informative abstract two is for psychology report. Somebody read. Please read anybody.
Example. Example of abstract. Here are two abstract with the key
you
part.
Start reading number one.
First one is model descriptive abstract. Abstract Stephen Sun, 2004. The opportunity to design and deliver short programs on refreshing and avoiding plagiarism. For
plagiarism का मतलब क्या होता है? Copying from the internet.
For transnational UNI essay student has confirmed the necessity of combating both the or plagiarism is cheating reaction and thus just give them a referencing guide response. The notion of referencing is but the tip of the particularly large and intricate iceberg. Consequently, teaching referencing is not adequate in educating students to avoid plagiarism. In this presentation, I will use the transnational teaching experience to highlight what educating to avoid plagiarism intends.
What is the person talking about? He is giving the background and he is giving the purpose and aim and what is the particular focus. So what is the background? An opportunity to deliver short programs in referencing and avoiding plagiarism. The person is advocating for advocating to deliver a short program and encouraging people to avoid plagiarism. This was the background. And what is the purpose? He is highlighting the purpose and aim. What is it for? Students of? Yes. And what is the lastly, what is the particular focus of the paper?
Just give them a referencing guide.
Yes. So you can see कितना छोटा है और ऐसे ही आपको भी बनाना है. Now the model. The background you can read, the purpose you can read, aim you can read, the methods used. Please read somebody. Read. पढ़ो तुम कोई पढ़ो.
मॉडल इंफॉर्मेटिव एब्स्ट्रैक्ट सेकंड वन इज एब्स्ट्रैक्ट जॉल्जन 2005. मेटा लिंग्विस्टिक अवेयरनेस कंट्रीब्यूट्स इफेक्टिव राइटिंग एट यूनिवर्सिटी. राइटिंग इज द मीनिंग मेकिंग प्रोसेस वेयर लिंग्विस्टिक कॉग्निटिव सोशल एंड क्रिएटिव फैक्टर्स आर एट प्ले.
इट मींस इन राइटिंग लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स आर इंक्लूडेड. इट मींस your mental makeup, what you are thinking, what you are feeling, what your experience is, everything is displayed in your writing.
University students need to master the skill of academic writing, not only for getting their degree, but also for their future career. It is also significant for lecturers to know who our students are, how they think and how we can best assist them.
All right, this is the background. And now the purpose and aim.
This study examines first year undergraduate Australian and international engineering students as writers of academic tests in a multicultural setting at the University of Adelaide.
All right, Adelaide. Now the method used.
Questionnaire and interviews where youth collect data about students' level of mental linguistic awareness, their attitudes towards, expectation for, assumption about and motivation for writing.
Now the result.
The preliminary results of the research show that students from different cultures initially have different concepts about the academic
genres
and handle writing with
academic academic style.
Genres and handle writing with different learning and writing styles. But those with a more developed meta language are more confident and motivated. Then conclusion.
Now the conclusion.
The conclusion can also be drawn that students' level of motivation for academic writing positively correlates with their opinion about themselves as writers. Following an in-depth multi-dimensional analysis of preliminary research, some recommendation for writing instruction will also be presented.
So these are the two abstract and very defined with background, purpose, and aim, methods, results, and conclusions. So what you need to write, I gave you the topic already. So you will follow the same points. You will just write the key points as given. And if I have not shared this with you, I will share this in your group so that you will get a better idea. Did you understand?
Yes.
So I made it very simple to you for you. Write the abstract of Rahul Bajaj or any either of the three, and do an informative report. Some questionnaire method, some interview method. You can interview a lot of students, and for their extracurricular activities, you can see how many students are interested in singing or dancing or drama, or you can, I told you, it can be on COVID-19 and what steps they are taking, what are they feeling, have they been vaccinated. It has to be done by you. Today you are in a better position, you can video record them, you can talk to people in your campus, you can talk to students whose parents are, who may be the people who, students who have had families of COVID-19, who have survived, unfortunately some friends who are not there anymore, some people who could not make it. So the choice is yours. You can video record there, or you can questionnaire them. But these are the things you need to do. I told you in the very first place, business English is just not reading class. You have to understand, you have to do a lot of work. Okay. So I hope the assignment is simple. Writing an abstract on Rahul Bajaj or Narayana Murthy or Subhash Chandra. Right. And if you have any problems whatsoever, you can always get back to me. And I would suggest, why don't you read some abstracts on Google? See how, this was just an example, sample. But then you can also read some abstracts.